It is an oft-repeated, though only mostly true, fun fact that the holdings of Condorman have been with the family since before the French Revolution, an extremely rare state of affairs in Burgundy. With the winds of change blowing in 1789, the original owner, Nicolas Marais, shrewdly sold his elaborate chateau for fear it would be confiscated by the revolutionary government, while retaining his vine material. This little maneuver worked, as all around him, the social order of Burgundy was overturned, with the extensive holdings of the church and the nobility confiscated by the government, and in turn sold to the local and Parisian petite bourgeoisie. But technically, these lands would not come to the Counts of Armand until 1855 as part of a dowry. There is still a Count Armand at the top, although the Counts have always been wise enough to place all of the power and trust in the hands of resident winemakers. And they've shown great audacity in the choice of these winemakers. This began in 1983 when they plucked Pascal Marchand from relative obscurity in Quebec. A curious choice in tradition-minded Burgundy. Then, in 1999, they hired 23-year-old Benjamin Leroux to convert the entire estate to biodynamics, again, very unusual in Burgundy at the time. Both men have gone on to found esteemed, eponymous estates of their own, and this may be the future for current winemaker and Leroux disciple Paul Zanetti as well. So when you open a bottle of Comte d'Armand, it's kind of like drinking the modern history of Burgundy in miniature. It has its roots before the Revolution, is transformed by the social upheaval of the 18th and 19th centuries, and today it serves as a cradle for some of the greatest winemaking minds of tomorrow. We are very excited to offer Comte d'Armand's Aligoté, a classic fresh and mineral expression of Burgundy's second white grape. Aligoté is a fantastic pairing for cream dishes, seafood, and anything at all featuring goat cheese.